Here we are introducing. We have conducted lots couple of online courses and various aspects, but this is our first webinar, so it may some technical issues. Sorry for that. Myself is Prabhu Poonaswamy. I'm leading the hydroelectrics and research and hydroelectrics research and analytics solution private limited in Delhi NCR and registered in Tamil Nadu. Basically, we are doing many research and analytics support for across the domain of health aspects and other domains also. It's recently opened a private limited consulting firm actually. It's a 3 years old actually, second year, third year is happening. So recently, we are fully full-fledged. We are launching the our consulting firm actually. So as a part of, we have done a couple of trainings and a couple of trainings due to the COVID pandemic. We have conducted many online trainings. As a part of, we have tried to build a new way of approach of bringing a webinar also. This is our first webinar launching. That's what we are introducing as a first we are introducing Dr. Hari Gurunjan. He is a former professor of HOD in Madurai Komaraji University Statistics Department. He is well known to everyone, and he is a statistician across the in South India. He is well known to everyone as a mathematical model. Many models he has developed, he has constructed many, bringing many remunerated students in across the things. He is well known for across the statistician and mathematician. In South Asia, he is a part of many positions like a UGC Emeritus Professor, retired UGC Emeritus Professor for Madurai Sundararao University, and as well as also former CSR Emeritus Scientist for MK University, and former chairperson for mathematics mathematician, and a senior professor for statistics and Department of Head of Applied Mathematics Statistics of Management. He is a 3 decades of experience in statistics and health research activity. He has associated with many policy and committees, national and international importance. He also authored in several papers and books and reports. It was a pleasure to invite him to have a fruitful presentation on introduction to R. Those who are new to R, for them it's a wonderful opportunity. I know from 25 years, Dr. Hari Gurunjan as a well-known technology bringing the as a statistician, as a computerized or artificial. Nowadays people are talking about artificial intelligence, all those things. But in 25 years back itself, he has introduced R and to many professors like that and students like me. He has got many supported in many places. So it was a pleasure to, as a hydrologic research, he has a pleasure to invite Dr. Hari Gurunjan to have a fruitful presentation and a great. You to go ahead. Yeah, please go ahead, sir. Please start your.
Thank you, Mr. Prabhu. Is it audible to you?
Yeah, it's audible, sir. Please go ahead.
What about everybody?
Yeah.
Particularly, Professor Venkateshan.
Yes, sir. It is audible, sir. Audible, sir. Yeah. Thank you. We see Professor Jyoti Kumar is listening very carefully.
Yeah. Okay. Now I. Right, so from beginning, good evening to everybody. When I say good evening, this is from my end, but some people may be far away places and it could be some other time. I want to thank Mr. Prabhu for providing this platform for knowledge dissemination. I'm very happy about that, because nowadays when somebody learns and you should share with others, that's the best way to learn. Actually, I was the beneficial fellow, because I, for the last 10 days, I started collecting many more examples. I worked and saw whether the examples are working, and I took the screenshot and I included here. Well, as Prabhu pointed out, I'm going to talk about the R software with special reference to social scientists, because R is widely used by academia and industry, And to my surprise, I recently saw that many psychologists and sociologists are also using R. So when Prabhu asked me, I went to the internet, I found that there are many more examples. So I carefully selected the examples from that area, social sciences area. Well, I want to say only two things here before I start. We collect data. Can you see the arrow, Prabhu? My movement? Okay. Because I don't know whether how people are viewing it. We collect data. The data has information that you have to extract. From the information, you have to deduce the knowledge. From there, you have to generalize the wisdom. This is the knowledge generation process. That's how science progresses. And not only science, every science, even social sciences, political, mathematical, physics, everything. So our aim to get information first, then knowledge, then wisdom. So for that is one process. Another one is your data has a given pattern, or I can call model, or you can call this information, knowledge, and wisdom. Everything is hidden here, but the noise is hiding it. So statistics helps to generate knowledge. Please note that we are not going to create the knowledge. A scientist collect data. He can use statistics to generate knowledge. Statistics uncovers pattern. That is the model. Now, R accomplishes all these activities. That's the most important thing. That's why R has become a very handy tool for everybody. These are some simple and some guidelines for me. What are the topics I'm going to cover? But of course, I'm not going to follow linearly. So I will simply progress from one end to another end, but taking a detour. Now the main question is, what is R? R is a simple and easy to use statistical language, or you can call a simple to use a graphical programming language. Please note that there's a difference. You do not know anything about statistics, but you are interested in using graphs for your research, for your publications. Without knowing anything about the statistics, you can produce a wide range of graphs. That is possible in R. Moreover, R provides a computing environment. Please note that every software is trying to attempt, but they don't. So it's the important computing environment. It allows you to explore your data. Every software does, but this R software helps you explore in new ways. R helps you to learn and use statistics effectively. This is the most important thing for me. As a teacher, my students are using programs, software, but they always click, produce output, voluminous output, but they don't understand. So this can be used to learn and use statistics. Well, finally, I want to conclude, our program is simple, flexible, powerful, and highly productive. Well, saying all these things, you should not develop a Benz or add a car. This is not a very fanfare equipment. Now, it's very simple. Don't develop anything. I am giving the caution. R does not give any clickable menus, pop-ups, and dialogues. So it simply gives you one small window. There is a prompt and a blinking cursor will be there. And you have to start typing your command and press enter. That command will be executed by R. Now the important things, commands resemble statistical terms. So if you want to compute mean or median, variance, correlation, a simple word is there. Okay. In that way, this is very simple to use. R actually provides flexibility in computing. If you are in doubt, please wait. Within a few seconds, I will be able to tell. Now, I told you that there is a simple notepad like Elter. There is a prompt blinking. You can't use any escape sequence. That is a control or F cap, alpha, beta. You can't use. Therefore, you have a good type here. This we call command line interface. Command line interface, we simply say CLI. CLI is common for many software. Now I'm going to give you to get a simple understanding on R. I assume that there is at least one or two people who do not know about anything about the R. But I can see that Professor Jyothi Kumar is here, Dr. Vengarajan is here. So many more people are there, they know about the R. But I assume at least one audience is not does not know R. I assume that. Now at the prompt, you type your commands or an expression. 4 + 5 * 8. Some long time back, I learned Fortran and BASIC. Then after writing, I have to enclose it and I have to give it a function, print, view, run, like that. In R software, simply type and enter. What do you think you expect? 5 * 8 × 5 = 40 + 44. But if you expect 4 + 5 = 9, then into 8, it won't do. The computer programmers have developed a certain methodology. So they always do the multiplication or addition or power. So if you want to compute adding first, then multiplying, you put in parentheses. Okay. So this is another expression. In order to avoid confusion, I have put a sufficient number of parentheses. So many times, you can not only use simple plus, minus, square root, or square, and so on, but there are built-in functions, sine, cos, tan, and so on. Now R is programmable. So you want to compute amount of principal amount. Say you are having 1,500 rupees. You want to lend at 6% per annum. After 3 years, what do you get? It's very simple. Even a calculator will do it, but I just do it here and I will tell you in what way R is better. P equal to 1500. I am assigning the value to a variable. I am assigning the number of years 3 to n. The 6% is actually 0.06. That is assigned to R. The formula is very simple. A equal to P * multiplication. I put parentheses 1 + R raised to the power n. This is a very simple compound interest formula. You type at each line, you have to press the enter key. After this, you type A and press enter key. You'll get this. What is this? A square bracket, a number within square bracket. This says one output is there. If there are more outputs, next line will indicate the order or index of the output. Okay, let us come to that's not very important at this time. You may think any other program does this. Okay. Now, in what way R is different? Look at this P equal to something, N equal to something, or now I make a change. N equal to a collection. This is important. R makes this convention. If you want to collect, see, bracket 2, 3, 4, 5, this is a collection. Now again, you call this function, A equal to P * 1 + R power n. Immediately, mass people will object because it's a scalar quantity. You are raising to the power a vector. This is not allowed. Even computer programs will say this is not correct. But R will do one thing. You start computing P and 1 plus R raised to the power, there are 4 values. So you take the first value and you compute. Again, this another value. It does the same thing again for 3, 4, 5. Therefore, when you ask for A, you'll get this. Please see that index 1, first result, second result. The third result, you need to count. So it gives the index 3. This is the fourth result. So this cannot be performed in a pocket calculator or scientific calculator. In usual basic and Fortran, C++. But nowadays, many computer programmers are trying to implement this in other languages. For instance, Python, Julia, and so on. So, simple formula, but you can tweak it to compute here for very many values. In R, you can write formulas naturally. Many of you, if you are from social sciences, you'll be already afraid of this formula. Your statistics book says yes, variance formula, 1 by n, sigma. There is a parenthesis within the x minus x bar square. And now, I ask you this. This, we know it's mean. Here, you are summing and dividing by n. Again, mean. So, you can do it like this. Mean, bracket, that's a function. Within that, another parenthesis, x minus, again mean. For this parenthesis, you raise to the power 2. But what is x? I think something like, you can see here, down lights, x is something like this, a collection, 1, 3, 5, 7, 9. Okay. So, if you look at the formula, it resembles this. Please note that in your statistics classes, you are asked to compute this. Almost many people will not do it because of numeric and formula. But now, this way, you can easily write the formula. You do not need a programmer to write a program to compute this. That's one point. And because it is very simple, you not waste your time on understanding this or computing this. You can go to the next level. Suppose you do not want to do this type of computation. There is a built-in function, var bracket x. This is called variance of x. So immediately it gives the variance, but sometimes the people complain, this is different, this is different. We'll discuss later. So similar to this, many more statistical functions are available. These are built-in functions. If you want to write, you can write another function. This writing a function is very simple in R. This is covariance. Wait a minute, I can have some pen pointer option. Wait a minute. Pen, okay. So the you got some functions, minimum, maximum, range, IQR, and so on. You have to just remember, or once you start using it, you'll be able to use the correct formula. Now, I told you a simple calculator, a programmable calculator, and you can write the formulas very easily. Now, I'm going to say about, what is this? This is not going out. You have a data set. Your text asset, oh, it's not going. You have got a data set, assume that it has certain variables on weather conditions. First variable is date, on which date it is collected, location, which area, minimum temperature on that day, maximum temperature on the day, rainfall, whether it was rainfall, it could be some measurement, evaporation, and sunshine. Then there are many more variables. Actually, this is data from a weather bureau from Australian Coast Guard. Now, you may be having more than 12 variables. As a researcher, you get a lot of variables you collect. Now, assume that I want to compute mean values of only these variables. There could be many variables. I have to select the variables. Then I want to have the fifth variable is restricted. You should take value more than one. What is the fifth variable? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Rainfall. If rainfall is more than one, sufficient amount of rain is there, then I want to find the mean value of what the three minimum temperature, maximum temperature, and rainfall and sunshine. So, in general, taking something from database, you need a programmer are a very complicated program. Now, think of this way. You are asking somebody to do it. What do you say? Take the data, select only three, four, five, seven, only these columns you select. Then condition to only one particular way, select those rows which satisfy this. So take data, select variables, filter it. When you are giving condition and selecting rows, it's called filter. And then mean, it's a very straightforward. Many programs, they are very complicated. What is the specialty here? This is take data. You can see that a percentage symbol, a greater than symbol, percentage. This is called pipe. In our program, we call it a pipe. What happened? So, take data, pass it on to next. What is the next activity? You select these variables. That's one activity. So, the original data we have been told are 20 variables, but we are going to select only this. Everything is removed. Then pass it on. This is another pipe. Here, another activity, filter. Filter is to select the rows. Remember, selecting column, direct. Selecting rows, use this word filter. And everything to pass it on to yes function mean. Don't you think that this is a very, very simple, powerful language? That's why SPSS creator Norman D. Yeah, he said the most powerful statistical programming language created on earth is what he said. Okay, some statistics. To conduct a t-test of H0 mu equal to 40 using a data, weight is already I am given here in the bottom. Usually your teacher or colleague says, take the data, do a t-test. In other software, you have to open a dialog box, you have to enter the data in some windows like Excel sheet. Then pull down a menu. There you have to select the test and you have to select these values. Now look at the command we have in R. T dot test. This simply, my God. See, in statistical people say t-test, proportion test, normal test, CORD test. So you have to simply follow that language, t-test. This is the data variable, your hypothesis. If you do not give, it won't complain. If you take mu equal to 0, and automatically it takes alternate equal to both, because you can have one set of hypothesis, both upper side, lower side are symmetric, and you may want to have the fixed p-value. Everything you can include here. Please note that this is the place you put a comma and start writing it. You do not have to search your menu boxes and dialog boxes, click something. So straightforward. How do you run linear multiple regression? Suppose I have got marks, final marks, assume the internal Gibbs box, then you want to see whether the internal Q affects marks. This left side is y equal to a plus b into this. If that is what your regression, the simple command is lm marks tilde. Think of this y equal to a plus bx on left hand side of the equation is the dependent variable. Hatton and share the independent variable, so they're the same way. The only thing they said till day. Why did they put equal? Equal is for some other purpose. Okay. Now, you want to do analysis of variance. The formula is simply A over V. This is a command, A over V. Again, like this, weight and tilde. Please note that weight is some 13 entries are there. Group is one first sample, second sample, third sample. You would indicate by a grouping variable. By just typing it, clicking or entering, you'll get the solution. Okay, you have got a data, a rectangular data, many columns, many variables, many rows. In that space, in for that data, you want to compute the factor analysis. The command is fact anal. This is the basic command available in your R software. But sometimes people write very beautiful software or package. This is psych. This psych package written by a psychologist for the benefit of social scientists. So you want to use the factor analysis available in this package. So the convention is write down the package name, double colon, use the variable. Please note that some other sub package will may have the same FPA. Therefore, it is better refer to the package and then type the command. Then this is the data file, the rectangle data file you already inputted. I will tell you later. Apart from this simple construct, they accept options that control the output. So this means more flexibility. You do not hold a mouse. You do not click buttons, menus, and so on. Please note that even SPSS, it has a lot of dialog boxes, but its full potential is obtained only through commands. And many more, which are not available from the menus, you can get it SPSS only through command mode. So this is not new, but this here in SPSS in AR, this powerful. Please note that SPSS was written 40 to 50 years back. Those days, the computer hardware is different. Drivers are different. Even input output is different. Now, over the 40 years, they simply updated the software, but they do not cope up with the current technology. But our software is written from scratch, just 15 years back. By the time C language is born, and object-oriented programming, that was created. So our software uses that those new techniques. Okay, then next. Now you should appreciate the power of commands, typing commands. I write a create a vector. Here is a sequence from minus pi to plus pi a with a gap of 0.1. Pi is 3.41. So minus 3.41 to plus 3.44. So you have gap of 0.1 means nearly 70 points are selected. You need not worry about that. Next comment is very, very elementary. That's what we say. Plot X against sin X. X will go to the X axis. Sin X goes to the Y axis. So once you click this, you get the plot. But if you want to modify the output, you can go on adding this. The same command, main equal to, within quote I write, that comes here. While lab, whatever it, that comes here. Then type L. See, these are only four or five types are available. Without specific means dots. If you put L, lion. So see the difference. Here, collection of dots. Here, a smooth curve. The COL for color equal to blue. Now you can see the difference. This is black, this is blue. And many more commands are available that with simple commands, you can get a beautiful picture in R. Now, if you want to see that, go to the Microsoft Excel, take some data, ask it to produce. Those pictures are not comparable to R output. Now, after explaining this, I don't want to go on explaining, but I know you are from some, most of you from social sciences are away from science. So it's you want to get the bore out of R. Now, as an example, I simply click, I saw some simple slides. See, there are two outputs I given. The data set is cars. Data set is empty cars. This built-in R, it is available. You need to search and copy it here. The x-axis having weight of cars, that is mileage per gallon. This is American data. So nearly 32 cars are selected. Their weight and their mileage is plotted. You can see that this is coming like this. That means what? If you move from left to right, say this, if you increase the weight, the mileage per gallon goes down. That's natural to expect, and it is depicted. The plus thing is, look at the histogram shown here. For the weight data, a histogram is drawn. For mileage per gallon, here the histogram is drawn. So that gives you an idea about the distribution of these two variables. Or sometimes, if you want a box plot, I think this is hiding. Okay, I can look here. The middle is the median. This is the left side is the first quartile, third quartile. This is the length width in which most of the data will arise or occur. This is the external abnormal data. So this simple picture gives conveys many informations. Another set of box plot. Now I am using a data MPG. I am using MPG, a data set available in another package, Tidyverse. Please remember, please wait for some time. I will tell you how to get these packages into your system. Okay. There is a package. There is a data set. There are many more variables. I am taking the HWI, highway miles per gallon, on y-axis. Here, different type of vehicles. Pickup, SUV, minivan, two-seater, and for each variable, a box plot is drawn. That tells you the distribution of the highway miles per gallon for each. So you can get the median. So highest is here. Others are even, I think these two are equal. So mid-size and compact have the same median. And for compact, there are more outliers. Compact, there are more outliers. Some vehicles are having high mileage. Here, for two-seater vehicle, there's no higher values. For SUV, the 90% of data is within this area, but there are outliers, the 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 variables. So a picture gives a lot of information. Other packages produce the same thing. Now they have started producing it, but R is an expert. Now look at this. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Popularity of American names. Sometimes in some time period, we have the same name repeatedly used by people. This Amanda, Ashley, Betty, from 1880 to 2010, how many people had that name? Distribution is plotted here. So in a single plot, we are giving a highly comparable pictures. In a single plot, I have given three plots. Here also, the data is empty cars. The first y-axis is Q set. x-axis dot. Now you may wonder, what is the meaning of Q-sec and dot? Now if you are in R software, you ask, simply ask for help, empty cars, help within bracket, empty cars. It describes the complete details. And the Q-sec is the thing, but quarter mile in second. Here in our manufacturers say that 60 kilometer, how much time it takes per vehicle. That is the one criteria. Drought, I don't know why they put D. The RAT means ratio. Rear axle ratio. This is the meaning. But this can be obtained from the help, you know. The, here, the number of cylinders, 4 cylinders, 6 cylinders, 8 cylinders, for each one, the Q-sec. Q-sec is the quarter mile in second time. That is, to reach a quarter mile, how much second is needed? That data is here. They have put the box plot. Here, cylinder, and you count them. In your data, 4 cylinders are so much, 6 cylinders so much, 8 cylinders. Now, please note that I created the 3 plots different at a different as an object and arrange it first row. Second row, there are 2 columns. I can do it this way. Only 1 column. Second column, I can have 2 rows. So that is the flexibility. You can have even everything is in 3 rows. You can arrange it. But I thought this will be more interesting. Okay, I am trying to explain the various facilities. Now, why are nowadays people are competitive? If something is available in one software, another software is being introduced or improved, improvised. Now, R has got certain important difference between other software. Other software ready-made. They are written with a clear, some definite ways and to produce only certain things. SPS, if you want to factor analysis, it is written and it produces a large number of values or output. But if some other discipline, they want a different interpretation, different output. That's where R comes here. R does the same thing as SPSS or SAS do. It can be suitably modified by either by you or your friend or another programmer. And I'll tell you, how can you get a different tailor-made modification for your R? Extensive offline. Many books written by authors, they are published by CRC Press. They are available offline. You can download from net. You can keep it on hardware, hard disk. Online. You can read online. That is allowed. Something like mathematics or physics or chemistry, electronics. These books cannot stand the timeline. Within a year or two, they are outdated. That's why they give the books in offline. They allow us to read. If needed, some people buy it. The large community of helpers, that is the most important thing. If you do not know, you simply go to the internet, you Google it. How do I do it? How can I do it? Google will search and put you in a different web pages. You can browse and get your answers. It is intuitive. For instance, SPSS have the same commands like for mean, median, multiplication, and so on. But I told you SPSS was written 45 years ago. Now they want to include matrix. Now it struggles. Yet they have to use a different type of symbols. But R is an object-oriented program. That means multiplication for scalar, multiplication for vector, multiplication for matrix. They can be suitably rewrite the program. So you can simply intuitively, you can't say this matrix, I have to do this type of multiply, this type of operation to multiply and so on. Cooperative with other programs, this you should not underline this, underestimate this line, because nowadays every program connects to another program, it works. For instance, if you have got the data in Excel, biologists will always connect to Excel, get the data and they compute and put in another place, put in another program, say Word. they want to write a report. Take data from Excel, compute, and put it in a Word. It is possible. But please note that some programs are not easy help us to understand, because you look at the maps, Google Maps. Do you think they send every time a map to your smartphone? No. If there is a road, they send the points. These points are plotted and connected by straight line. If there is a car, the many more points are sent to you. Therefore, their data is not rectangular. Please note that SPSS, Excel, and many more software handle rectangular data. Okay. In that case, R connects to map software, for ArcGIS, use take data or use the data available there. Okay. Finally, I want to say, not finally, they continue. The graphs of wide range are produced. They are all publication quality. Next, solves wide range of problems. I think I can rush through because I am taking some more time. But I want to say this: textual data analysis from tweet data, you won't get a very simple option set. Ticking. Suppose certain number of people, they say, I like this, I don't like this. They don't say in a very clear term. They express in many ways. So after taking the textual data, you have to extract information, linguistics and natural language processing. In all these things, other softwares are just trying to reach, but R already has gone through this. Collaborative research, this is an important point. Now everybody is talking about collaborative research. Microsoft Word allows it, and even SPSS. But the point is, when I contact my collaborator in some foreign country, I can't simply say, pull down that menu. There is an item, you click, there is a dialog box. Choose the fourth one, take the seventh one, and so on. I can't say that. But here, everything is command. You can type the command, he can also execute. Nowadays, online journals are asking the data and your formula, what are the methods you used, and they want you as an add-on package so that they can verify. I know that some people lost their chance of publishing paper because they are not able to give the suitable data which produce the same output they gave in their report. This is now things are changing. Okay, new statistical procedures are immediately implemented by experts. Immediately is available as a package. So I would like to say, the best way to use R is to use someone's package. You do not have to take any package. The internet is flooded with packages. And if you are in social scientist or biologist or psychologist, a businessman, somebody in your area already worked hard and they produced a lot of packages. You have to just check for it. So the term used in science is stand on giant's shoulders. Somebody has written it and you can use it. Finally, R is free. I think I spent more time, but I want to give more examples. And the package have a function. This can be modified. Okay, now the number of packages are 10,000 plus. More is growing. When I started, nearly 1,000, 15 years back, right? Okay, now, what do packages contain? You take a statistics textbook, they give data, they write a formula, they demonstrate how to compute the formula. Don't worry, the functions are already have some certain names. If you call it, it does that particular computation. So explanation of how to use, there are sample data sets are also given in the packages, and you can check the data because not just ordinary collection of numbers, the source is given. If there are variables, what are those variables? That the information is given and examples for using the function and sometimes you can check the formula employed. Do you know how to compute the median? I know. I arrange it and do something. But if you go to the R, it describes nearly 11 methods to compute the median. So that's a way everything is clearly given to you. And the methods used by the particular package and what is the source of research paper, it's also given there. Now, it is interesting, but you may ask, how can I get a package and use it? Please note that all the packages are available on this website. Sometimes authors who wrote the package, they have got their own web page. Nowadays, all these people are trying to put it in GitHub. This is one convenient place. It's free and people keep it whenever they update. And the old version are pushing down and the new version will be there. So people are doing it. So from there also you can download. Okay. There's a web, the package P you want, you have to download using certain internet connection. You know the problems. You download, unzip and install and so on. But here in R, you start in R session, the command mode. I tried to put the greater than symbol. Unfortunately, PowerPoint makes havoc. It starts sticking off a bullet. So at the prompt, you type install packages bracket P within quote, of course. It does this. What is the mirror? It knows where to take. If you say the nearest mirror, that you have to set. Otherwise, by default, it takes the nearest mirror. From the web, that is downloaded in zip format, then unzips and installs in various places where it's supposed to be. You need not do anything. Everything is taken care of. And moreover, next line is library P. This is a command you have to invoke. So the package is in your hard disk. But you want to use it in your R session. Please note that there are 10,000 packages in web. Your computer may be having only 200 or 300, but everything is not available to it. You have to bring it to the R session. For that, you have to invoke the command library P. Okay. After that, all the data, functions, everything is available to you. I think I'm giving you sufficient information. Next. Okay, let us do something. The data set cars, it is already available. You need not have to download and put it. I told you, Base R has 31 built-in packages. Already it comes with it. You do not have to download it. One is cars. There is MAWS, MAS, and there are many more, okay. These 31 packages have enough in data, you can use it. Now the cost data has 50 rows and two variables like this. Speed is one column, this is the speed and distance traveled. So there are two columns to get an idea I have given here. Now you want to find the some summary statistics for speed. What is the minimum value? What is the maximum value? What is the mean, median, so on. You have to issue only this command, summary. Because cars is already available within this, you do not have to say anything about cars. You can put dollar speed. You can simply say speed. Otherwise, many more time it's better. It's always better to give the name. The package name and the variable inside. To differentiate this, there is a dollar symbol. This dollar symbol is there, saying something, a component of, the speed is a component of cars. This is a convention. Sometimes you can type attach cars, then you need to specify the cars at every time. Okay. Now, when I say summary, this, what are you getting? Minimum value, first quartile, median, mean, third quartile, maximum value. So look at the mean and median. They're almost equal. What is the difference between median and first quartile? 3. Median and third quartile? 4. So it is symmetrical data. Okay. Well, you may ask one thing. I have to say this comment for every variable? No. For all the variables in your data set, you simply say summary cars. Immediately it understands there are whatever the variable names are there. For everything, it computes the minimum, first quartile, median, mean, third quartile, and so on. Please note that this is the flexibility, simplicity. That is, you need not say speed, distance, okay? Every time. If you want to compute for all the columns or all the variables of your data set, you simply summary cars. Now, the most interesting thing here is you do not have to depend upon the Bayes summary. There is another package, psych. This was written by a psychologist for the use of psychometry people. There, they are given a command, describe. It does the same thing like a summary, but it put a lot of values. Number of observations, I think this judge. Mean, standardization, median, trimmed mean. If there are abnormalities on the both sides, that will be 5% lower side, 5% and higher side, it trims, removes the data and computes the mean. MAD, mean absolute deviation, minimum, maximum, range, skew, kurtosis, everything is available from the psych package. So all you have got is load the package and use this command. But when you say describe, you are referring to psych. For that, you can type like this, psych, double colon, describe. Because that describe is available in another package also. So every package it is, they do not create new names. They create a very simple, understandable names. And there is a package, HMIC, and there, this actually produced by a geographer, actually. This package has got a lot of utilities. So once you use this package and use the command describe on cars, it gives a detailed data, detailed statistics for speed and distance. Even the each value, how many times it has occurred. But here, distance is not a discrete one, it's a continuous one. So lower values is given here, upper values of some five upper values, some five lower values are given, right? So it's important that you need not have to write all the function, use the correct package. Okay, this is not the only way to do it. There is a package called JASP. JASP is one latest software released only in 2019. It is Jeffries. That is, Jeffries is the name associated with the Bayesian. This gives a lot of Bayesian methodologies. Please note that this is important. So, once you use that package, it's easy to where is this? Where is my data? Yeah. What happened to my pointer option? Okay. So just go to the JASP. You load this data. This is a very famous Iris data. Then this package, just simply click, that's all. You do not have to put your finger on the keyboard. It produces. Now, how can I take this to my report? Right click, Control C, go to the Office or Office product, Microsoft Word. Again, right click, paste. It goes there. Then you can modify, you can delete some of them. Okay. Well, now, plots. The base R comes with a package called empty cars. It has got many variant weight, mileage per gallon, displacement, gears, board of gear transition, etc. And if you want to know what are the values contained, you use the word head. The command is head. Head means top six lines. If you tail, bottom six lines. So the names and the six records of on MPG, cylinder, displacement, HP. If you want to know what is represented by draught and HP, you simply type help empty cars. It gives all the details. So I got some, actually 32 cars are included and there are 11 variables. I am going to use this set for my demonstration and a command plot weight comma MPG. Weight goes to the x-axis, second component goes to the y-axis. Very simple. But of course, this command will not produce this. For the presentation, I made a small change, a comma, certain label done. Okay. So it's very simple. You do not have to go to some menu and click the dialog box and so on. Now, I simply use plot empty cars. Please note that empty cars has many variables, many columns. Here, only two columns I am calling and put in the plot function. It understands this should go to the x-axis, this should go y-axis. But when I see a many columns data set, it does not comply. That's the advantage of R. It is written by OOP. So all the variables, for instance, 11 variables, I can't show it. I have taken only 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Six variables, a matrix plot. How to read this? For this plot, what is the x-axis? Go down, find it. What is the y-axis? Go left, find it. So instead of looking at the lower triangle, look at the right triangle. See, please understand that when you collect data, nobody says which is correlated, which are not correlated. So you have to explore. This is a best research. Almost all statisticians at one time, they will do this to understand which variables are correlated. This is actually correlated and this is not correlated. Okay. Now, how do I compute the correlation? Again, the command is COR. You need to type all the characters. First three, it understands. I give two. If you get only one, it computes. Two variables, MPG, DISP. So these are variables in my package. Immediate outputs, minus 0.841. First, you note that minus, negatively correlated, high correlation. So it's not perfect, but high correlation. Again, I want to compute the correlation for all pairs. I can't go on issuing the commands. So better I can do this. Car, within bracket, I can put the package name. Under car, I put this. It won't comply. It understands. But not to create this, it is very large. I can't accommodate in this page. So I set only 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 variables. It's a very simple trick. Once I create a new data set, I put car empty one. You may ask, why not empty cars? A matrix of 11 by 11, I can't put it here. Moreover, it gives 7 digits. I tried to put only 3 digits. So I put the options and did this. You do not worry about this. You have to understand this. A car function takes a two variables or collection of variables. Okay. Sometimes you want to test. Actually, did I say that? Previous. I think it is there. To find the correlation, use the car. To test it, car dot test. I told you, t test means t dot test. The comma is there and I think it is okay. Immediately it gives the necessary details and the probability of significance value it gives. Otherwise you can't compute r by square root of 1 minus r square. divided by square root of 1 n minus 3. No, don't waste your time on computing it. Okay, now the HMSC package has got one function R car. Please know the how do I remember this? No, you go to your net, you try to take one particular package, list down. If some professors already given you these things, you make a note of it. Then same thing, the empty one data set I am giving here, it gives you the coordination values for two decimals and the corresponding significance probabilities. I should not be able. If you think this, whether this is very very small, can I take it as zero? You propose a hypothesis H naught rho equal to zero, then the probability is given 0.33. So you do not reject your hypothesis. Whereas here, I can't remove the 0.78. I can't say that is equal to zero. So my hypothesis rho equal to zero. According to this, I can't accept or reject. So here, for MPG and HP. So this is something strategy you have learned. But I want to tell you that the value and probabilities are given here. Moreover, some people do not like the numbers. They want some. They are allergic to numbers. They want to get immediate. Yeah, they want to interpret. So look at the right hand side, blue color to red color. So blue color means high correlation, red color means high negative correlation. Look at this, always blue, but if you go and inspect it, this is a negative correlated high correlation. This is also positive correlation. This very very small 0.04, the value is small, right? So please note that for demonstration only are given, but for this I used Spearman correlation, but the other options are in Pearson, Kendall, Spearman. So what is the package? There is a package name called CarPlot. CarPlot is a package and use this. Moreover, now I consider all the variables. I will put the square word plot. Thing is, I use the word upper. I get the upper one. If you put lower, I get lower. Color means everything, but there is no circle, square, pi. For each play circle, it is represented by pi diagram. They are all more informative. Next. It's a heat map. This heat map is used in physics and geography. From remote sensing maps, they use the word they do not want to have you the numbers for a map. They do not want to put the correlation values. So here, I use the command, you can see later, but the red means direct correlation, high correlation. Green means not correlated. Or in other words, actually negatively correlated. So think of this, there are 1, 2, 3, 6 rows, 6 columns. So there are 36 cells are here. If you allow it to put, it gives a different colors. I restricted to only 3 colors, green, white, red. Otherwise, it gives again a simple diagram. If you go to the particular package, there is a heat map package, then it gives various combinations and so on. Now this is the one of the finest diagram created by R. So far, to my knowledge, no other software was able to do it. See, for five variables, MPG histogram, displacement histogram, HP histogram, in each histogram there is a envelope is enforced on it. So two information is given. Here points are plotted. Again, smooth line is given here. It's not a trend line. Maybe trend. This is the. It's not a linear. Okay. And here the correlation values. the stars are saying that it is highly significant and so on. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and numbers are going down, small 7. The size of the number matters. So 7 aspects are giving one picture. Other softwares are trying to produce this. I have not seen anything like this. Okay, now come to our research ideas, research topic. Most of the time, we social scientists collect contingent data and they try to cross. Wait, what is this? Cross tabulated. Cross tabulated data. So 13 tasks, laundry, main meal, dinner, and so on. Wife is doing certain times, husband is doing certain times. Sometimes they do both jointly, or they put say alternate. I do this day, tomorrow you do that, or morning I do this, afternoon you do this. I like that. This is a data, a typical cross tabulation. I think I always put a typical cross tabulated. Whenever cross tabulated data is available, people immediately do the computation of chi square, O minus E whole square by E, and you need not do this for this data because there are 13 rows and 4 columns, huge number of values. So you ask the R software, the chi-square dot test. If you have the name for this data set, you put the name here. It actually, I worked with the house tasks. The chi-square, they don't put chi because R does not deal with the Greek letters. X squared, the value is very, very large. It is significant, 2.2 into e power minus. Actually, it's very, 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 very zero. Therefore, we can conclude the row and the column variables are statistically significantly associated. You can't say they are independent. What is not independent? House tasks, the work shared with the husband or wife. Many times people say, sir, I collect so much information and you are saying only one line. Can you give me some more information? So they ask, can you do some exploration? Okay, that you can do it. That is the purpose of a software or statistics or the package. Now, usually ask them to interpret. Look at this. Laundry work will be 156 by wife and the husband is doing only 2 times. But whereas the repairs were done by husband 160 times and insurance matters taken by 53 more. Usually, husband jointly by both, and holidays both enjoys 153 times. Husband and wife, wife is not doing enjoying it. Husband alone enjoys. So you can go through these and ask them to interpret, but they find it somewhat difficult. So I want to say there is a balloon plot. It's available in base or see this picture. The large in numbers are given a large value, smaller. So you looking at this, you can try, you can write your report. Laundry work mostly done by wife, husband is not doing. Insurance and finance matters done by both or husband alone. Repairs work done by husband alone. Holidays are enjoyed by both, right? So using looking at this dot size, you can try to infer something you can write. If you think it is still difficult, now I ask them to compute the observed value. The observed is actually what you collected. What is the expected value? If you think the row and columns are independent, then under that model, the chi-square function computes expected value. Then you simply write a formula, is called O minus E divided by E. We call Pearson residual. It is computed here and plotted. What is the advantage? Each value is something like a T test or Z test. Actually, I should say Z test. So if it is between minus 1.96 and plus 1.6, it is not significant. More than 1.96 is significant. So look at this is not significant. This is not significant, but this is significant. So wife is preparing breakfast. She is doing more than expected. And the independent model, what she do? How many times she does under independent model, but she is more doing a positive value. Negative value is lower. So even if you think this not actually this helps you to write a very interesting report for your paper, even if you do not want to do this, there is another one, a mosaic plot. Everything to bring a common height. The hard line is for positive residual. By residual, I mean O minus E by square root of it. This I call residual. So then dotted line is called, this actually for negative values. And the color indicates whether it is significant. Violet color means highly significant. Red means highly significant on negative side. Okay, this gives you a simple way to present or include your report, or using this you can get some inferences. This is available in a package called VCD. Wherever possible, I give the information. This is a 4x4 tool. See, this actually I'm going to write a mosaic plot. I don't want to waste time because I think how much time I have, I don't know. Let us go back to regression. People always take the data, fit a regression and compute the R-square. They immediately write a report, but don't do it. Because different type of data are here. There is no relationship for this. Here, everything is going in some direction. One extreme value pulls the line. So here it's going and coming down is a curve. So for all the data, the fitted line is almost, not almost, simply equal. I didn't give the equation. The R-square value is also the same. So what you do is, you simply apply this formula, LM. Good. This is the Y equal to the independent variable. It immediately gives two values, intercept and the coefficient. Use this here, use this case, y equal to a plus bx. But this is the first model we're building. We can interpret using this. For every 1 hour, this marks will be increased by 2.7 units. That's the interpretation. But before that, you have to justify your model, use this command, summary. So, another output is given, the same intercept value and slope value coefficients are given, but here, in addition, whether there's the actual probability value is given, they're highly significant, 3-star, highly significant. And the R-square value is here, adjusted R-square value is here. Whether they're significant, yes, highly significant. So this one indication to use before you use your model, before you justify your model, you check this. Next important thing is diagnostic. Other software gives, but here very simple command. You simply say plot your model. Name you, that is my mean model means that regression model. Did I give the model? And this line, you put some name and accent here. So you represent this by name, then under plot command, use that name. Immediately it gives 4 plots. Using that, you can check. They should be very erratic. That's very important. This should be a straight line. Other things, okay, I don't want to spend more time here because Now, or for sociology, I am going to present some network, social network, to get the idea, to get some information about social network, at least for my understanding. I consider Tom, Ben, Bob, John, Mary. These are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 persons are here. I additionally have put whether they're male or female. And the age is also given here. Well, the age means I am going to represent the relationship, friend of. I know Tom is a friend of John, Ben is a friend of John, Bob is a friend of John, Mary is a friend of John, and so on. So I write this. So what I have written is very simple. Node means point. The 8 points are there. From one point to another point, if they are friend, I give here. 2 vectors are given here. Finally, I am going to use a package, iGraph. This is a very powerful package. It is a free, and you load this. You look at the library iGraph, then use the command graph data. This you can't remember. You always look at the manual. Then next page, I got the network diagram. It gives very clearly. No, it's not very clear because already we know who are friends. But now, yes, graphically I represented Tom, Ben, who are friends, and given this. The most important things, I know this is a boy, this is a boy. Already I have this. I color them. Blue color for boys, pink color for girls. Now this gives an idea. The boys are friends, girls are friends. This is the exceptional. A boy is a friend of girl. But now with this, you get an idea what is social network. With this understanding, let us take an arbitrary set. I consider 10 individuals. I give them 6 questions. The questions ask for a response, yes or no. Now after getting this, I look at this. The L, Y, pillar Y is giving yes for Y1, but same way, the person J is giving yes. So I expect Y and J must have some common similarity or social relationship or something. Okay. Looking at the yes, I can try to create a matrix we call adjacency matrix or similarity matrix. For example, Y and Y cannot be zero. Y and B do not agree. Y and F do not agree. Y and H are agreeing on one thing. Y and J are agreeing upon one thing, and so on. Now, once I can create it, it's not necessary, but to understand this, I draw a network diagram. This explains how clusters are formed, who are related. In social networks, this is an important aspect. Okay. Wait a minute. I took an arbitrary data. Then after doing this, I get a social network diagram. Now for your information, I have given all the commands just for my remembrance. And if everybody wants it, I can take this. You do not click something. You simply copy and paste in your R session. You get this picture. It is 7:26. When do we stop? Prabhu?
We can go another 10 minutes, 10 to 15 minutes.
Okay. Now, then this is an important personality project. If anybody is here on from psychology, there are many theories are there. One important is 5 broad dimensions of personality. They are named agreeableness, conscientiousness, extraversion, neuroticism, openness. See, each person's personality is a combination of these five variables. We can't observe the five variables directly. So, something like love cannot be observed. Handsome cannot be observed. We can put certain questions, we can get the information. From that, we can try to know about this. Similarly, the personalities. So, a project has 25 items. This is standardized. And of these 25, each five measures, one of these, 1, 2, 3, 4, they call big five. So this data set is available from this area, these two websites. You can go there, you can get it. And the last one is actually, whoever visits there, they ask you to undergo the test, right? Okay. Then the data is collected. I am not giving all the information. This particular website gives everything. Now, you got a network diagram. Please note that the five big fives, agreeableness is given pink color. And extraversion, green. Neuroticism, blue color. So, those five questions are given the color. Agreeableness, these are measured with these five, they're given the same color. And so, the whole three, openness, this is, yes, there are five questions. They are shaded by the color. Please remember in previous diagram, I put the male part blue, girls pink, like that. This is given. And how to interpret? Look at the arrow, the connecting. If it is green, it is positive. If it is pink or red, it is negatively correlated, negatively associated. If the thickness is very high, this is highly correlated. If the thickness is very small, small correlation, right? And I have taken only one picture and using only one particular measure, there is a correlation. But the empirical Bayesian method is there. They can draw it. And for male respondents, female respondents, what is the diagram? And many ways you can draw this and you can try to understand the personality dimensions. Okay, I think this is next. Okay, now what do I do, Prabhu? Should I
what we can do it actually, we can just go through the last that what are the features that additional application that you can link it, that you can explain, and we can close it.
Okay,
yeah, that would be
then
better.
Okay, these are something, some packages and things are there. These are okay. Now, R as a learning tool, many people want to learn statistics. They think that learning R, they will be learning statistics. No, if you should know statistics, then only you can learn R. But for application side alone, you can use R. Now, if you want to do something, go to the Google, open it. Type this, how do I do this activity or find correlation, draw network diagram, or simply this procedure in R, you type in the search box, it gives a large number of websites, then you can choose and you can try to understand or go through them. Many universities provide detailed notes. Data used in those books are available from the website. This is the great way to learn. Please know that you need not have any statistics teacher. You can learn by yourself. Okay, you can always find a suitable R package. Now we'll come to that. The important R as a productive tool. This one aspect. See, I have written a report in MS Word. There's a title. There is a report. I say a sample of 7 values yielded a mean of 9 and standard deviation of 6.53 something. I didn't use Word. My computer does not have a Word. I used R. or produced this Word file. I used a Word software to open this. How will you do it? I write, these are this 10 or 9 commands are, sorry, this is 7 commands are content. It says the title and which one is the default. I think I have made a mistake of eraser. Okay. I want to produce a Word document. I write here colon default. If you want to have HTML document, I delete this, I write here. If you want a PDF document, I should add one more line, PDF document default. So header is indicating what is the report I have to prepare. There is a data and computation. This is my data. These are my computations. And this only for reference. This command echo false means when your report, when you find a report, the R will compute and post on to this. Look at the data I written here. A sample of n values yielded a mean of m and standard deviation of s. The only thing is I want to refer to these things. So what I do is apostrophe or backtick R and close. Here also backtick R, then a gap and the value I computed. If you want to hide the information from the original report, I put echo false. These are very, very simple, easy to use. So I get a report like this. Now, what is the advantage? Suppose if I am having this, my collaborator says, sorry, sir, I got one more value I got. Originally, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, what did I have? Seven values, okay. Now add one more value because usually we make a change. We add data or remove data. These are very simple, but think of a huge database. Some columns are added and so on. Add one more variable. Now what will happen? I needed to go to a software, do it, bring it here. Okay. The thing is, the only thing I change here, immediately my report changes a sample of not 7, 8 values. Yield a mean of 10, a standard deviation of, I got it. This is very, very best for collaboration. Provided, most importantly, your collaborator is far away. My collaborator is in some place, Kuwait, and another person is in South Africa. So usually I send emails, I do this, you do this, and so on. So Microsoft Office Word allows you to collaborate, but not the computation. Okay, the final is, you write only once. You can create a Word format, you can put it in your web page, you can prepare a handout in PDF, and a Beamer presentation. Originally this software was prepared by Beamer. Then in order to use the pen, I convert it to PowerPoint. From one source, I get a PowerPoint. There are many more presentation methods available. For instance, this is the first report, Word document. Now I got the Word document. Then I got a HTML. That means I can put in a, I can see it in a browser, or I can send to my friend, he can see it in a browser. Many teachers, whatever they write, they put in an edit, simply use converting to a web article. This is a handout in a PDF format. And this is a Beamer presentation. First slide, second slide, third slide, fourth slide. And you can take another type of presentation. This is called Slidey. You need not have Adobe Acrobat or anything. Once you prepare Slidey, use the internet connection, use the browser. You maybe have Edge or Firefox and Chrome. The first page, you click it, second page. Click it, third page, fourth page. So many times you can use one source and convert to many different formats. This is not possible any software. Finally, only one thing. I think this may be interesting to you. People who are not interested in typing the commands. So there are GUI. GUI means graphic user interface. RStudio, this is the de facto standard in our computing world. From novice to advanced people use this RStudio. Without this, it's very difficult to work in R. If RStudio was not invented, nobody will be working in R. Then R Commander, people still wants to click. I don't want to type commands. R Commander, this is built on R. Please note that built on R, and by clicking menus, again clicking other menus, and statistics, there are many commands, many items, and sub menus are there, almost similar to SPSS, but it's not SPSS. Under graphs, you get a list of various plots. You do not have to write any commands, you simply click. Rattle, rapid as a R analytical tool to learn easily. This is mainly written for data mining. If you are working on data mining, this is the one important, very powerful software, and you can also use to learn R. And this is RK Word. It is written originally in Linux environment. Now it is available in Windows platform. It is simply powerful. I think either use Rattle or RK Word. Now, this is our output. Blue Sky Statistics Program. This also built on R, but it's a commercial. But a free version is available with minimal. Minimal means number of dialogues you can open at any time. That is only 5. But for that, this is very simple to use. Again, clicking. And the outputs are neatly formatted. And the graphs are also beautiful. This is achieved through R, but you do not have to work hard. This will take care of. Similarly, JASP. This is written only just last year. See, so every day, every month, they add packages or modules. They call modules. So once you open it, there are some, not even words, some pictures. Data is clicking here, then you load your data. If you click the descriptives, two lists are available, and this very blank. Once you move variable to another one, this is populated. Please note that instantaneous. If you remove one variable from this to that side, they change. Here one variable, here another variable. This continuous, this is a disk factor. So for both, it gives the values. And for logistic regression, you take the data, click the regression, there are classical and Bayesian. That is more important. Nowadays, many people are asking, well, how to do Bayesian, right? Once you move the items, it automatically populates this area. If you remove one variable from this side, this also changes instantaneously. JAMOE, I don't know why they put the JAMOVI, but people who wrote JASP are taking part in JAMOE, and this is the most recent one. And I know many foreign universities, they are disconnecting SPSS and they are using JAMOE for their teaching statistics. Because here also you're going on clicking. The menus are similar to this JASP. Okay, but I think I stop here because there are many more pictures are given. Even this took me nearly 1.5 hours. And I think, Mr. Prabhu, what do we do? I think I can stop now.
What we can actually, thanks Dr. Ariyuranjan, actually what we can do, it actually we'll share the presentation to every participants. That's would be better. Actually, it's a, we have extensive presentation, extensive work. It's almost 1.5 hours. We have gone through many things.
There are still more. There are many more.
Already attended. many more. What we can do it, actually, we can share the presentation to the participants. They can pitch in from there and there onwards. That would be better.
That's why I given enough here. Documentation. Yeah, I stop here.
We can stop here. I think it's a wonderful presentation. It's almost almost wonderful.
Prabhu, 40, you 40 don't minutes. Say that. Yeah. If any chat box, if anybody is there, anybody said something?
I
don't know whether people are there.
No, actually, we don't have any much questions on. I am just looking at the things. There is not much questions on that. We can ask the participants to send a message if any queries on all those things. We can share the presentation also. It's once again, thanks to everyone. There is an extensive presentation. It's informative. It's almost because we are expected some 1 hour planning, but it's because the extensive it's gone. It's very nice to have this kind of extensive presentation. We'll share all the materials to you that would be helpful for your in a future reference and all those things that we'll share you in both the video recording as well as the material we'll share you. Thanks to everyone. Thanks to the participants and thanks to the presenter, Dr. Arivaranjan. It's a wonderful presentation to be here.
Thanks to everybody.
Thanks to everyone because we are...
Thanks to Mr. Prabhu.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Yeah. Thanks to everyone. It's very nice. Thanks. We'll meet very soon. We are planning to have a couple of next present sections also. We'll get back to you soon. Thanks to everyone. Yeah.
Oh, 20 then people are there. Very good.
Professor, very, very, as usual, you have done an excellent lecture, Professor. As usual,
Professor.
You are very good. So, you are bubble flat. You are going to do something. You are wonderful. Thank you, Professor. Thank you. Thanks for your.
I think I got this.
You
the great man. You are congratulating. Very happy.
Yeah, naturally I saw your name and then I thought I should be there. No, because
but if you are appreciating it, then I should be very happy.
Yeah, very nice. Very
nice.
You initially told even one person who is not aware of this, and you want to walk on to the lowest level so that people can understand easily. That's the most important thing. Advanced things, I think only for a couple of people we need. Other things, you know, how you can use it. Particularly from social sciences you have taken, most of the time you'll go for biological data or some kind of commercial data people will be going. And particularly social sector
I addressed, yeah. So far, I talked to
really very nice. Very nice.
I talked to computer science people. And statistician and mathematician and people.
Social sciences is a good thing. Very nice. Thank you, Professor. Really, really,
congratulations.
You have to thank the organizers for making this kind of arrangements. Really, so all the credit goes to the organizers and as usual. So, really, it's great. Thank you, Professor. Thanks for your nice presentation. Really, I'm very happy.
Thank you. Thank you. Prabhu, you have to give me the, if the respondents say something, you send me the information.
I'll do it.
Hello?
Yeah, please.
Hello, Jyothi Kumar.
Professor.
Yeah, please.
Jyothi, please. I am very happy you attended this.
I have attended, but my laptop collapsed me.
I only told him, no, connected, because initially, sir, why it is disconnected? I said, no, I am seeing this, please connect it once again.
I thought it was, you have a problem, but I have a problem. I had a problem, network connection is not there.
Yeah.
That's the problem.
The current system is not...